Hey, you can't do that. I've got rights, you know. I know my rights. But rights without responsibility is wrong.
Boss man, read them now, rights.
You have the right to suffer. You have the right to feel pain. If you wish to have an attorney present, I'll hurt him too.
Oh, you've got to be kidding.
Hey, school is at home, you dunce cap. Hey, now it's time for us three men's to go out and beat those two men's, because it's the law.
I can't believe it, Barry.
And it's time for another unbuckled bumpy ride with your guide, the star-craving lean-atic himself. I'm Jim. Let's jump right in again. Welcome to my podcast based on my brand new book, available on Amazon, Live Life Lean, L-E-A-N. It's a year-long guide to gratitude and our daily grind. The book that combines some timeless wisdom from a whole lot of the world's wiser people with the reflections, reactions, and wisecracks of the guide's author, me. And it guides you, the reader, through the simplest system for a happy, healthy, authentic, and genuinely grateful everyday experience. I urge you to get the book. Of course I do. I wrote it. It's either at Amazon or at my website, amperage.com. AMMPURAGE. But even without it, let's make next week better than last, our next year better than the past, and get started now with today's episode of Rights and Responsibility. Some amazing quotes through time from some amazing minds. The rights of every man are diminished when the rights of one man are threatened. President John F. Kennedy. And we can disagree and still love each other unless your disagreement is rooted in my oppression and denial of my humanity and right to exist. James Baldwin. And then there was, everybody wants to talk about their rights and privileges. 25 years ago, people talked about their obligations and responsibilities. Football coach Lou Holtz. I wonder why is that? I wonder why that is. Is it because the balance and contrast of rights and responsibilities has changed so dramatically? Or is it simply supply and demand? That whatever the quantitative balance of these two, that when shifted or imbalanced in one or the other, you reflect on that which is most, you know, closely self-centered. Is it that 25 years ago we had more responsibility individually and familially and neighborly, communally, and as such that was in our conscious forefront? Or is it that now that the demands of responsibility are diminished enough that we reflect on rights even though we only have the luxury to discuss them because we have the time to now with a different balance of responsibilities? Or is it that, truth be told, responsibilities are unpleasant when we have them, and rights are unpleasant when we feel we don't, truth be told. The most profound truths are plain and simple, though often not easy, and that leaves us with an uneasy feeling inside, a feeling inside that does not just go away so easily unless it's addressed. These truths of which we're speaking right now, once we've been exposed to them, the truths, well, they honestly, they just kind of straggle along wherever we go in our day-to-day life. Like a stray that wants its master, like a child that wants its leader, these truths grow truer and loom larger the longer we neglect the reality of our having them, addressing them, accepting, or making exceptions for them. But see, that's the thing about truth. It doesn't have to change to adapt itself to you and I. Truth doesn't need to fit in. Truth is, we need to adapt to truth. And we need to find and figure out how it fits us and how we will fit it into this crazy world once we've acknowledged that truth. And doing so is a responsibility we all have in order to claim any single one of our rights, even the big three, the God-given rights of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Strongest truth, simply put, but not easy to put up with. The quote was, "Your rights are my responsibility." I didn't originally say that, but I'm going to say it again. Your rights are my responsibility. One of the most profound quotes I've ever heard, and it came from a Canadian. Yep, Canadian professor Jordan Peterson. He was saying that anyone having the conversation about them, about rights, or anyone at all having any rights at all, was an empty claim and an empty argument without addressing the perspective of responsibility. Because he said, and I think he was right, that when someone says, "I have a right to," whatever, you know, fill in that blank there, then your right to was my responsibility. And it immediately resonated with me that, yeah, if you have a right to something, I have a responsibility to not something, to not take it from you, to not interfere, to not persuade you that you do not have that right. But you have even more responsibility than I. So you have not only the responsibility to treat others the same way, to recognize others' rights, taking equal responsibility, if respect, if nothing less, to not remove that right from their reality, you know? But you also have the responsibility to pass that on and preserve it for posterity. Because if you let it die with you, then you're not recognizing the same responsibility as those who came before you, the ones that preserved it for you, so that you may claim your rights. You did not ask them to take responsibility to not remove your rights. I get it. I know. You didn't ask them to. I know. But on this crazy celestial surfboard that we share called Mother Earth, if they hadn't, you might not have those rights. If they hadn't responsibly not set up a system to provide for the sustaining of those rights, those that would someday be and are now your rights, and protect them for what was then, what they called back then posterity, and what you and I now call our current reality, well then, what rights would we be claiming and clinging to? You know, life, liberty, the pursuit of happiness, etc., etc., etc. But by insisting on those rights today, you implicitly expected the responsibility of those from yesterday to both defend and protect, and then pass them on to you. Your rights came with responsibility. One cannot exist without the other. Your rights came with the responsibility on someone else's shoulders to, for them, bear that burden, or to deny their own desires, either way, or both, to not do anything, for them not to do anything towards those things that would interrupt or prevent your rights. Because rights, the rights most of us insist on, well, they're rarely earned beyond the effort involved in surviving childbirth. Yeah, we fought and wriggled our way out of the womb. But the moment we did so, we were dependent on others to provide for and care for and all the responsibility on us from others. And life, this world, and God gave us the right to that life to be lived in this world freely. And if we're really lucky, we might even find happiness in doing so. But our right to all of that was someone else's responsibility, their responsibility not to crumble, crush, or kill it. And it's therefore our responsibility to do the same for those whom we have not maybe even met yet, those whom are yet to come either into our lives, into our homes, or, oops, into our wombs. Right, yours, mine, theirs, rights. Rights do not exist without responsibility. Your rights are my responsibility, and mine are yours. Ouch. And all our responsibility for recognizing that, or rights as we identify them will cease to exist. So now, laying down all that heavy, do you still insist that you have rights? Well, I do. I insist that I do, and I argue that you do too. And those rights, yours and mine, by the acceptance of their very existence, those rights just existing, insist that we are responsible for not crumbling, crushing, or killing them. For others, on our planet, on our block, or even just on our still-yet-to-be-here radar. Recognizing rights for ourselves and our fellow cosmic dirt surfers on this crazy world of ours, recognizing rights without taking responsibility, is wrong. Now, ain't that right? And now, you have the right to remain silent.
But you don't have the right to keep me silent. I ain't shutting up yet.
Because I got more words of wisdom to wow your socks off from the Live Life Lean Guide itself. This time, entry page 57. What the expert said, I have always served the public to the best of my ability. Why? Because like every other man, it's to my best interest to do so. Cornelius Vanderbilt. And the guy's point of view on this? Those were the days when what are now called politicians were once duly and proudly called elected public servants. Those were the days, meathead. So what do you think about this? Using the Live Life Lean Guided System, what have you learned recently that's new? What have you earned that wasn't just handed over to you? Where have you added to the world that was not just about you and recognized others? Now, be grateful for all of that. Reflect on it. Respect it. But before you navigate somewhere next, just know you have the right to like, subscribe, and the responsibility to share to show you care. Thank you for listening. I hope you're enjoying your copy of the Live Life Lean, L-E-A-N guide, enjoying it almost as much as I did creating it. And if you don't have a copy yet, go on over to amperage.com or Amazon and get started today experiencing the amazing power of knowing every day is literally yours to be grateful about. And you need never feel unfulfilled again. I'm Jim Hall. And until next time, good health, God bless. And now, go get a little dirty learning something new. Earning what's not given to you. Adding to this crazy world that we share. And navigating your way to something new. And next.